Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so I'll quickly revise what are the topics we discussed so far from class 1. So we started with the first program, like writing C# program and structure of C# program and Hello World C# program in the first class. And then we saw how to compile and execute C# program without using Visual Studio. So we compiled it using CSC compiler, and we saw that when you compile, an exe file will be created, and that exe file can be executed. So, and we also saw what is the use of Visual Studio. So using Visual Studio, you can code very quickly. You don't need to remember the spellings, or Visual Studio will have IntelliSense. So when you put dot, it will show you all the methods available for a class or so. So that is the reason why we go for Visual Studio, for better productivity. And we also saw like what are the data types we have in C#. And so we saw like int, float, double, decimal, like we saw all the data types. And we also saw what is the range for a few data types. And then we saw operators in C#. So we discussed on like what are the different types of operators we have. Like we discussed on arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, and then assignment operators. Okay, like that we have seen different types of operators. And then we saw control structures in C#. So we saw a for loop, while loop, and do while, like one of you said, like we'll be explaining today. I think it's Seema. And then we also discussed on conditional operator. What is conditional operator? So today we'll focus on types of variables. So we have value type and reference type, and what is stack and what is heap concepts today we'll discuss on. And then we'll get started with functions and arrays. So these are the topics for today. And so we also discussed on what is number system and what is memory units. So we discussed this as well. So we saw like how to convert binary to decimal and decimal to binary. So we learned that. And we also saw what are the memory units we have, like byte, bit, and all. We saw that. And we saw brief overview about .NET framework. So what is class library? What is base class library? What is .NET framework class library? So all the DLLs which are present in the folder version 4.0, we call them as .NET framework library. And we saw that few DLLs like we saw system.dll. Or we saw system.web.dll. So all the DLLs are present in the folder version 4.0. Okay, so maybe we'll see this CLR, CTS, MSIL, JIT. We'll see this maybe today or in the next class. So for today we'll focus on types of variables, value type and reference type. And then we'll see stack and heap concepts. And then we'll see what is a function and what is the use of functions. And then we'll also see what are arrays and how to declare an array and what are the use of arrays. So this is the plan for today. So we'll get started with types of variables. Okay. So we have two types of variables. One is value type and the other one is reference types. So now we will see how we can differentiate these value type and reference types. So let me open Notepad. And then so now we have two types of data types. This is very important. So this is the topic which normally will be focused on interviews. So you should be very clear in this. You should be very, very clear in this value types and reference types. So please focus on the class. So we have two types of data types, value types and reference types. Okay. So now all the normal basic data types, all the basic data types which have fixed size or categorized as value types. So all the basic data types which have fixed size, for example, if you declare like int a, or if you declare as float b, so these variables will have fixed size of integer will have 4 bytes, so float also will have 4 bytes. So these variables will have fixed size in the memory, so these are value types. So for example, if I declare like this, assume that I'm declaring int a is equal to 5, and then assume that I'm declaring int b is equal to 8.8f or whatever. So I have declared like this, and then I have declared here int b is equal to 10, and then I have declared again int c is equal to 20. So I declared 4 variables total. I have declared int a is equal to 5, b is equal to 10, c is equal to 20, and b is equal to 8.8f. So now, if you want to understand how these are stored in the database, so let me open an Excel sheet. So let's assume that my computer is very small computer. So I have this is my total size of my computer memory unit. So now let's assume that each cell. So just a second. Let's assume that each cell of the area which is selected is 1 byte. So each cell is 1 byte, and this is my total computer memory space which I have selected. So I'm just reducing the width of it so that now. Okay. Now assume that the total size of my computer is only this much. So let me copy this, and then let me put it in a Word document so that it will be a bit clear. Okay, so I'm just opening it. So let me do one thing. So page layout and orientation, let me make it as landscape. Okay, so now what I was telling here is let me assume that this is my computer's memory unit. So now just a second. Okay, so now if I have declared variables like this, for example, so I have declared variables like this, so a is equal to 5 and b is equal to 10, like this I have declared my variables. So in that case, the memory will be allocated this way. So let's assume that each box is of 1 byte. So each small box is of 1 byte. So what happens is, if a is equal to 5, so okay, just a second, I'll make it so that we can see both the windows at the same time. Okay, so the moment you declare a is equal to 5, so for the variable a, 4 bytes will be allocated in the memory, because the size of integer is 4 bytes. So this 4 bytes, whatever you are seeing here, will be allocated for a. So what I'll do is, so now this is, what happened? So only these cells I'm merging, right? Okay. So I don't know why it is increasing the width of. Okay, so now let me see how it happens in Excel sheet. Just a second. Okay. So now I'll see how it happens in Excel sheet. Okay. So now, okay. So here, if I merge these 4 cells, because integer a will take 4 bytes, so I'm assuming that each cell is 1 byte. So if I merge it here, so this one will be taken by a is equal to 5. So the variable a is holding 5 here, which is taking 4 bytes. So now I have declared here b is equal to 10. So b also needs 4 bytes. So here this next 4 bytes. So each cell is 1 byte. So next 4 bytes is taken by b is equal to 10. So now I'll format this. I'll actually do a merge cells. So I'll merge it. So now I'm giving b is equal to 10. So B will be holding value 10 in this 4 bytes. So now again similarly we have next 4 bytes. So next 4 bytes, let's assume that we have one more here. So next 4 bytes will be taken by C. So I'll do again similarly how I'm doing here. So merge cells, so I'm taking here C is equal to 10. And the last one which I have is float B is equal to 8.8F. So float also, as you know already, it takes 4 bytes of memory. So I'm just selecting so merge cells. So now I'm taking 8 this one, let me give D. So this one, so D is equal to 8.8F. Now what happens when I write in the next line, when I write something like B is equal to 20, B is equal to 30. So do you think, question to all of you, do you think this 30 can be stored in this 4 bytes? All of you, do you think 30 can be stored in 4 bytes? You can ping me in the chat window. Do you think 30 is enough to be stored in 4 bytes of memory? Yes, 30 is enough in the 4 bytes of memory, because what is the range of, even if you take byte, the range is 0 to 255. So definitely an integer which takes 4 bytes of memory, a very large number can be stored. So every time when you change some value here from 30 to 40, 40 to 50, like that, any value when you change, the value will be stored in this location. So now B value will become, instead of 10, it will become 30. B value will become 30. So for all the value types, every time when you change the value, that will be fit in the same cell, that will be fit in the same location where your previous value is there. Okay. So now let's assume like this. So now let me undo all this. So now I have something called here, I have string name is equal to Meg. I have a string here. So I have a string name is equal to Meg. So what happens? So for every character in C#, what is the memory you want? Every character in C# requires how many bytes? Yeah. So I'm seeing few responses. So every character requires how many bytes in C#? So for those, I see a few wrong answers. So every character in C# requires two bytes. Okay, so now, just a second, I'm seeing, okay. So I repeat again, integer requires 4 bytes, short data type requires 2 bytes, and float requires 4 bytes, character requires 2 bytes in C#. So now if I declare like this for name, what will be the size of this name variable? What will be the size of total this name variable? How many bytes? Please respond in the chat window. So I have total 3 characters. I have for this name variable. So what should be the size of this variable which has 3 characters? I want the response from all of you. Please respond in the chat window. So each character takes 2 bytes. So I have total 3 characters. So what should be the size now? What should be the size of 3 bytes, 3 characters? Yeah, as simple as that. Okay, so yeah, it is, so I have only 3 characters, so it is 6 bytes, not 8 bytes. So I have only 3 characters, like I have M, E, G. So if I do like this, so for first A is equal to 5 will be stored here, 5 will be stored here, and then next Next, 6 bytes, because for each character I need 2 bytes. So the next 6 bytes, so 1 2 3 4 5 6, so next 6 bytes will be used by the string for storing MEG. So here, if you see, MEG is stored here. So now in the next b is equal to 10 will be stored here. So let me do one thing here. Okay, so now b is equal to 10 will be stored here. Let me format cells, and then let me merge that again. So here I have b is equal to 10. So now let's not worry about this now for this moment. Now in the next line, if I put here a is equal to 25. So again, question. So do you think I can change this instead of 5? So what happens? A value will be changed to 25. So is 25 sufficient in this 4 bytes? So when I change A is equal to 25, is 25 sufficient in this first? Can 5 be replaced by 25? Yes, that will be replaced by 25. So I can simply change here 25. Now, I am changing the name. I'm changing it to Meghnad. Now I have here Meg, and after this immediately I have 10 in the memory location. Now do you think this Meghnad is sufficient to be stored in this instead of Meg? Do you think I can type Meghnad now? Please respond. Do you think I can change this Meg to Meghnad now? Definitely not, because what is the size which is required for storing Meghnad? Yeah, so what is the size, how much memory you want to store Meghnad, how many bits we want? Yeah, currently we want 16 bytes, but currently the name variable is only having 3 bytes. So for that reason, since we cannot change it, there is no way to change it, because immediately next, even I cannot write Meghnad here, because MEGANADH, because the immediate next space which is available here, we don't have gap. Immediately we have 10 here, b is equal to 10. Even if this is having some gap, we can actually MEG here, ANADH here, we could have come till here. So there is no way that I can change this data type. So for that reason, the designers, C# designers, have come up with value types and reference types. So all the variables which can be stored continuously from here, they constitute as value types, and they are stored in stack. So stack is something like which is continuous memory from the beginning. For example, you can assume like this. So let me tell you this way. So stack is something like, if the variables are storing in this direction, so we call it as stack from the beginning of the memory location. If the variables are getting stored, so we call it as stack. Now in this case, when I change Meg to Meghnad, since I'm not able to do it here, so they came up with some other idea, saying like every cell in memory inside in computer hard disk, like every cell will have a location, address location. For example, this cell, let's take that this 25 is having 4 cells. So this address location is, for example, take the address location as 1001. What could be the address location for this one, for this cell where Meg is starting? What could be the address for this cell? Yeah, it is actually 1005. Yeah, 1005. So now like this we'll have different address locations. So let's assume that this cell is having an address location of, so I'll just highlight it. This cell, which is highlighted in yellow color, is having an address location of, say for example, 1052. Okay, so in this case what happens is Meg will not be stored here. Instead the address location of Meg will be stored at 1005. So now what happens is, here it will take around 1 2 3 4, let's assume that it is here. So this is here. So address of this location, let's take like 1052. So now this meg will be stored from here to 1052. So meg, so m, and since it takes 2 bytes, e here and then g here. So this is how it will be stored in the memory location. So this one, anyway, let me try to merge it and then simplify it. I'm not going to confuse it. So now let me merge it. So here MEG will be stored. So now in the actual value here the address of this MEG will be stored. So what is the address of MEG? Address of MEG is 1052. So here 1052 will be stored. Now if the value of MEG has been changed from MEG to MEGNAD, so now what happens is somewhere in the heap, so somewhere in the memory location here MEGNAD will be stored. So here MEG, let's assume that this is two cells, MEGA and ADH. So somewhere it will be stored, and this address location, say for example, the address location for this is the address location for MEGA and ADH is, let's assume that 1088. So in that case, when I change MEG to MEGNAD, in this place, actual variable name, variable place, this will be stored 1088. So when I want to read the value of name, so it will directly come from, so what happens is, so it will come to here, the actual variable will be there here, name, which is actually holding the address. Okay, 1088 is there. Let me go to 1088 address location, and then let me get the value MEGNAD from here. So this is what is from the backside you are coming here. So this we call it as heap. And this from the beginning, if you are storing, that we call it as stack. Okay, so this is about, so why they are storing like this is because when you change the value of reference types, the size is not fixed. So since the size is not fixed and you cannot expand it because immediately you have some other variable, so you cannot expand it here. So in heap you'll have a lot of free space, so wherever available, somewhere the name will be stored, and immediately the address location, the first address location, will be stored here. Now again, if I change MEGNAD to Ravi or something, if I change the MEG to Ravi, so immediately Ravi will be stored somewhere here. So assume Ravi will be stored here, and this address location, say for example 1082, will be stored here, 1089 or whatever, 1092 will be stored here. So in that way, only address location will be stored in the variable for reference types. So this is what we call it as a reference types. For reference types, they actually hold the location. The variable will hold the location. The variable will not hold the actual value. So I got a question. This is when we declare where as reference type, right? Don't worry about where now. We'll discuss where keyword later. Okay. So for now, are you clear with what I have explained now? Why strings are reference types? Please ping me in the chat window if you're clear. If you're not clear, just ping me. I'll just give some brief explanation again. Why strings are reference types? Is it clear now? I got one response. Others, please respond in the chat window. Feel free if you're not clear. So if it's changed to Ravi, memory location will be different. Yes. If I change to Ravi, definitely this will not be stored here. Somewhere again, Ravi will be stored here. So RAVI, and this value, this address will be stored here. Yeah, right. It actually stores address location. It will not store the actual value. That is the reason why. Yes, strings are always reference types. Because if you try to store the actual value in that in variable, when you change it again, sometimes what happens that the value might be bigger than what the current value is, so which will not be fit in the same memory location. Like how we saw MEG is taking six bytes, but when I try to assign MEGNAD, it will not be sufficient here. I cannot store it here. But when it comes to integer, float or something, the size is fixed. Forever integer size is 4 bytes, so you, as long as you change A to 5, 10, 15, 100 or whatever, it will be keep on changing in this location only. But strings, since the size is not fixed, so we cannot actually store it in the stack. For that reason, we'll store the actual value in the heap and we'll store the address location in the variable. So address location name, variable name will be holding the address location. So if someone wants to retrieve the value which is there, first they should go to variable and they should get the address location, and then they should go to the actual address and they should get the actual value. As soon as you modify this name is equal to make to make nad, this will be cleared from the memory. This make will be cleared from the memory. This will be free memory now. Okay, so that will become free memory and that will be deleted. Again, this will become free space available for heap. So stack is, so this means space will be allocated for a variable as well as address location. Yes, this will have bit confusion, I understand. So just blindly assume that value types will actually hold the value of the variable. So variable will hold the actual value. See, now A will actually hold the value, variable will hold the actual value, but this variable will not hold make, will actually hold the address location, and then in the address, in the location of this address, you will have the actual value Ravi. So just very simply you can think like, in value types, variable will hold the actual value. In reference types, variable will hold the address location, and in that address location we'll have make. How many of you are clear? Okay, so in interview, if someone asks you why strings are reference types, can you give very good explanation? So you went for an interview, so the interview will ask you why strings are reference types. Can you give the explanation, all of you? Yeah, so one of you wants to explain this for just 2 minutes, for others, for everyone, why strings are reference types. Yeah, so they will ask you why strings are made to store in the memory location. Then what is the answer? So I got a response saying because strings are stored in some memory location. So all variables are stored in memory location only. Because string values can differ. Even variable values can differ, right? A is equal to 5, A can become 10, A can become 25. So you should tell this way. So all the value types will take fixed memory size. So if someone asks you to explain, you should be able to tell all the value types will be having fixed memory size. So even if I change the values, the variable the changed value can be sufficient, can be stored in the same size. But whereas if you come to strings and class objects, when you change the values, that values will not be sufficient in the previous memory which is there. So in that case, we cannot fit the changed value in the previous variable's location. So in that case, you have to change it in some other location. So that is the reason why strings are made reference types, because when you are changing values, the new value will not be sufficient in the previous memory location. Is it clear enough? So who wants to explain this? So what if I change int A to float A? You cannot change like that, it will throw error. So if you have int A and then you cannot write here float A. You cannot write here like this, because already int A is declared, then again you cannot declare float A here. Okay. So I got a question saying what if I change int A to float A? So that this cannot happen. You cannot have two variables. Also Okay, in that case, so first the question is, first she declared as int a, and then now she is modifying this to float a, or she is modifying it to long. So in that case, what happens is, every time when you change some code, you have to rebuild it. In that case, all the memory, this complete memory will be freed. So when you change some code and rebuild it, all the values will be gone from the memory and freshly it will store. So that long A will actually take 8 bytes. Okay. So when you change the code and when you try to rebuild it, these values will not be there in the memory. This will be freed from the memory. Okay. So now, can one of you explain why strings are reference types? Who want to take it up? Just orally, like, who wants to take it up? I just want to see some different explanation than what I have given. So, who wants to take? Can one of you please explain why strings are reference types? Just for a minute. Who wants to take this up? Whatever you understood, even if it could be wrong, but anyone. So I see a lot of you in the class today. So yeah. So who wants to take this up? So Babita or Bhavik or Padmini, Sandhya, Sarika, Seeman, Sonal. So just tell me why strings are reference types. Okay. So Sandhya wants to try it. So I'm just making Sandhya as maybe I'll just unmute Sandhya so you can just explain whatever you understood, you can just give it a try. Yeah, go ahead Sandhya. Hello Sandhya, I have just unmuted you but we are not able to hear you. Others, are you able to hear Sandhya? Okay, yeah, no one is. Yes, hi Sandhya, we are not able to hear you. Okay, looks like there is some problem with your microphone. Okay, anyone else wants to take it up? Just tell me why strings are reference types. So how about you, Bhavik, you want to take it up? So you have to take it, I mean you have to take this as an opportunity. So just got a chance to explain others. So if I were there, definitely I would have told. So Bhavik wants to take it up. So Bhavik, I have unmuted you.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we are able to hear you. Yeah, go ahead, please.
So basically, string holds the value as a byte, like whatever the name or the value you use that holds the location of that value. Okay. And when we change the value, that directs or that points to that particular location.
Perfect. So, but in interview, if they ask you why they have designed like that, instead of storing actual value, why the designers have made you to store the location instead of storing the actual value, why they have done like that? So what is your answer then?
Because string can hold, string can vary that value.
Right. Right. A bit more explanation. Yeah, you're right. Strings can vary the size. So if I was you, okay, yeah, you're right, perfectly right. Okay, let's so my question is Bhavik said the explanation perfectly. So he said like strings, actually the variable will hold the memory location. So whenever you change the value of a string, so the new memory location will be stored in the variable. Perfectly right. So my question is, why the designers are designed like strings should store the location, address location, instead of storing the actual value. So for that you should tell this way. So assume that I have a variable make in my string name. So if I change it to make from Meghnad, so that Meghnad, I mean a string will not be sufficient, will not, yeah,
string can be long enough to hold that value.
Yeah, you're right. So string Meghnad will not be sufficient, which cannot be stored in the same size which Meg is storing. So for that reason they made it as reference types. So is it clear, all of you? So just think this way. So if you're seeing my screen, since here I have Meg here, okay, so now when I change it from Meg to Meghnad, which will not be sufficient here, so definitely I want to store somewhere else. So even there is no way that I can increase make to Meghnad here, because this is already freezed. So immediately next I have this, so I cannot move this 10 to here and write Meghnad here. Okay, so for that reason they are actually storing the address location here and they are storing name somewhere in the heap. So question to all of you, performance wise, getting the value of reading or writing the value from value types is faster or reference type is faster? Which is faster, value type or reference type? So I see a few telling value type. Value types are faster than reference type. Can you explain why? You can unmute yourself and tell me why value types are faster. So Padmini, you want to say why value types are faster? So I'm just unmuting you. Maybe you can tell. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Value types are faster because when you do a type, it directly reference to the address where the value is stored directly.
Correct.
Whereas in the reference type, we have to go to the when we make. We'll in the reference type, the address actually has the address pointing to the value. So we have to go to the address pointing to the value, and then we have the value stored there.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect explanation. Yeah. So you're right, Padmini. Thank you very much. So here, as Padmini said, value types are faster because if I want to read the value of what is there in A is equal to 20, A is equal to 5 or 25, directly I can come to A and see that, okay, 25 is there, I can retrieve it. But when you go to reference type, when I come directly to get the value of make will not be stored there, only 1072 will be stored. So from this I have to again go to 1072. I have to again go to this 1072 location, and then I have to get the value whatever is there. So reference type is something like I'm doing double reference. I'm coming to variable, I'm getting the location, I'm going to this location, I'm getting the value. But value type is not like that. You can actually simply read the value from the location here. Now all of you, do you agree value types are faster? Retrieving value types are faster than reference types? So yeah, so Sandhya and Sonal, do you agree with me why reference types are faster? Sandhya and Sonal? Yeah, I didn't get the response from, okay. Sandhya, do you agree like value types are faster than reference types? Or you want me to explain again? Feel free, if you want me to explain again, definitely I can spend time and I will explain again. Okay. All variable values stored sequentially, yes. So does it depend on size of the value as well? No, it will not depend on size of the value. Normally, as long as if the size is fixed, for example, if you take float, double, decimal, long, char, all these things, the size is fixed, so they will be stored in the stack only. But
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.